where are you at? Are you in, are you at your local, in the counselor's office at your local high school?
I am not. Why? Does it look like that?
Yes. You're like a middle school science teacher.
It's Friday, and I worked really hard this week.
Welcome to my courtroom.
Oh, no.
What do you mean?
You're going to judge me? Cal, you're always judging me.
Yes. Listen, my whole goal today is not only to ask you what you're up to, but it's also I need to assess who you are, your whole entire identity.
It's Friday, and I worked really hard this week.
So periodically, I'm going to ask you some questions, and I just need to get to the facts about who you are, because I need to establish your identity. You okay with that? Well, you don't have to be okay with it, because I'm a judge in this. Is it true or false that your father is D.B. Cooper, the man who jumped out of a Northwest flight, flight 305, with $200,000 in cash over Mexico? True or false?
That is not my father. It's Friday, and I worked really hard this week.
Well, listen, Mike, welcome to the fourth edition of Whatcha.
Thanks. This is the third time I've been welcome. I feel really welcome. Thanks.
That's good, man. I'll keep saying it over and over again. I'm the judge in this. How dare you mock me in my court of law here?
How dare I?
How dare you? So, Mike, tell us what you're watching.
You know, I had been anticipating the Beastie Boys story, the documentary on Apple Plus. It was very good. I was super excited about it.
Wait, first of all, why are you interested in the Beastie Boys?
Yeah, I remember he's about 10 years older than me. So when he would take us
to... So he's 60? So let's get back to the Beastie Boys, man. Let's get back on task here. So your brother likes the Beastie Boys?
Yeah. So we were riding in his Buick Skylark.
Nice.
You know, with the rims and everything. And he said, hey, I bought you a CD. And it was Beastie Boys' Ill Communication. And when he played it, I was like, my mind is blown. It's Friday, and I worked really hard this week. Ever since then, I've always loved them. And when that came out, it was really fun to watch that documentary because there's like all these feelings came back when I first heard them. And
yeah, what channel is that on?
That's on channel 3.
Channel 3? What, you got a TV with a knob? Is it true or false that you were one of two thieves that disguised themselves as police officers and stole $500 million in art from the Isabella Stewart Gardner Museum in Boston on March 18, 1990. True or false?
I like to purchase art, so that is false.
So that is false?
Yes. Okay. It's Friday, and I worked really hard this week.
All right, Mike, tell us, what are you listening to?
Well, I was listening to the Beastie Boys a lot after watching the documentary. But the Killers, I love the Killers. They were supposed to come play in Orlando, but it's probably not going to happen now.
I'm sorry, who are the Killers?
Yeah, they are a rock and roll band.
Do they?
From America.
Oh.
Yeah, rock and roll.
America. Okay. What state are they from?
I have no idea.
Okay. What do you like about the Killers?
They have good sound, very energetic.
What does that mean, good sounds, my man? Tell us.
Sounds that are interesting that do not suck. It's Friday, and I worked really hard this week.
What's your favorite Killer song?
You
don't really know, do you?
The Man. That song, The Man.
No, I don't know that. Called? Keep singing it.
It's like,
How's it go?
It's like, I got gas in the tank. I got money in the bank. Yeah. I got news for you, baby. You're looking at the man. Who's the man? Who's the man with the plan? I'm the man. Serta, awesome, fad, lean. I'm the man. Come round. On up the game break. You can't break me down.
Are you singing to Kyle? Kyle, why are you looking like the Taliban?
Because he's judging me.
I'm judging I'm judging this guy. We're trying to assess his identity.
Why do you think he looks like
you're interrupting my courtroom, miss. I need you to leave.
Objection.
All right, listen up. Is it true or false? This is one I gotta get to the bottom of. Is it true or false that you had something to do with 5,000 blackbirds freaking out and slamming some buildings, telephone poles and trees, dying instantly on New Year's Eve in 2010 in a small town in BB, Arkansas? Is that true or false?
That is accurate. That is true.
Really?
It's Friday, and I worked really hard this week.
Okay, I got one other one for you. Is it true or false that you got James Evans Sr. fired from his car washing job because you were jealous that he made 50 cents more an hour than you? You probably didn't even know who
James Rainier? James Evans Rainier Jr. from England?
No, man. You don't know who James Evans Jr. is from Chicago? His son is JJ. Daughter is Thelma, and he has another
Michael.
His wife's name is Florida.
I do not. That's not true. Florida, it's Friday, and I worked really hard this week.
What are you drinking?
Well, Uncle Val's gin. I just drink that just straight.
And you just drink it straight on with no ice?
With a little ice. Yeah, one little cube of ice. Just a little bit. Yeah.
Is it expensive? Does it come in a plastic bottle or?
I think my wife got a good deal on it.
Oh, that's awesome.
I mean, I think we paid like $30 for it. It's a pretty good, it's a good gin. So I felt like it was a pretty good deal.
That's awesome. So the other thing you're drinking is an IPA.
Yeah, I like IPAs.
Yeah, you look like a beer guy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's Friday and I worked really hard this week. What makes me look like a beer guy?
Things.
What sort of things? You're the, articulate, your honor.
Listen, I'm the judge here. You're in my court.
Is that a black, what are you wearing? Is that like a, is it an actual robe or is it like a blanket? How come I can see through your head?
Because I'm translucent.
Okay.
True or false that your government name is not Michael Forrest, but MF?
Wow. It's Friday, and I worked really hard this week.
What are you drinking, Mike? What are you doing, Mike?
I already told you.
What are you doing?
I'm doing this.
No, what are you doing? You're being hostile right now. I thought you were learning how to make fonts better. Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, it's the.
That's awesome.
Still, yeah, I'm a big NASA Lego fan, so.
Why font's important, period? Like, let's explain that to us.
Oh, man, I could talk all week about this.
Well, don't. Only talk 30 seconds about it.
I think that letters and fonts, which are systems of letters, I think letters are the most mass-produced man-made thing. And without these little pieces of art that form sentences, that form paragraphs and construct thoughts and lead thoughts to ideas and actions, I think it's just at the very basic level of human communication, letters and these little pieces of artwork. It's foundational. It's very intriguing to me. It's Friday, and I worked really hard this week.
So different fonts convey different things?
Oh, yeah, completely. And so, you know, if you have a certain vibe or tone or mood, or you think of a certain project or audience, you make a different typeface for those different things.
So why is Wingding even a font?
Wingdings, it's Friday, and I worked really hard this week. It's pretty fun.
So you're getting better at drawing fonts, like your own.
I'm trying to, man. I'm trying to.
Your own font, right? You do have your own font out right now, right?
I have a couple.
What's the name of them?
Well, one that I spent about a year and a half on, one that I'm really proud of, is called Fidget Display.
Oh, that's right. Play that one.
Yeah. Yeah. Right now it's on sale for $5. So if you want to buy it, I don't know. I just felt like selling it for cheap. That's all.
You know, when you know that you made it is when your font ends up on the waistband of underwear. So is it true or false that you are a great family man, father, and friend?
I mean, I would like to think so, yes. You should ask.
All right, well, Michael, listen, thank you for joining us on this. Based on the evidence that have been presented and the answers given in regards to these questions, me being the judge, based on my wisdom and knowledge of the law and how it should be properly assessed and applied to ensure justice for all, this court finds that you are truly Michael Forrest. Go in peace, my son. Court case dismissed.
Okay.
Oh, hey. Welcome. Doing their latest song, The Benjamin.